Hello and welcome to the Slingshot channel. In the last video, I demonstrated this syringe arrow for this pistol. However, I thought it is necessary to improve on it. The issues that I have with it is that first, it doesn't eject too much of the cherry juice on impact. And also, I think it's too fragile. I think it breaks too easily. So I had to design a poison arrow that is more sturdy and also injects more liquid. So I came up with this. This is basically a standard commercial 50-cent crossbow bolt, but I attached a aluminum tube to it, and then I made this. So this is a pointy tip. It is hollow, however, and the channel goes up to here, where four holes will later on inject the liquid into the body of the attacker. So the idea is that on impact, this works like a turnaround syringe and presses the liquid out of the four channels here. So it would work like this. So to test this, we will let the two arrows drop down from about, I would say, 60 centimeters height. So you can see that very little liquid has been injected. Maybe enough if it would be really poisonous, but if you use like motor oil or something, that wouldn't be enough. That's a lot of juice. So now we will fire into this foam block. We're not using ballistic gelatin because ballistic gelatin has no blood vessels and therefore wouldn't be an ideal test media for this. Let's cock the weapon. So the injection was quite good. But as you see, very, very little liquid has actually been injected, if any. Now the new arrow. Now to make sure that it's not squirting out too soon, we take this little rubber ring and close the four holes so that the hope is that it will be pressed down so on impact so that the little holes will be opened then. Okay, let's look at what happened. Clearly the rubber ring was forced down. So you can see that the rubber ring was forced off, but you can also see that a lot of liquid got injected. See, it's completely soaked, and you can even see the four canals. So one more advantage is that you can fire this arrow also from this commercially available crossbow, which has about the same force as my homemade spy gun. So I think this is really a nice invention. It can also, of course, be applied to any kind of arrow, for any crossbow or for any bow. That doesn't matter. And I think it's highly efficient and not very hard to make. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks and bye-bye. We'll be right back.